Good day, everybody. This is Phil Aegis with Framon Manufacturing, and today we're going to go over the Sidewinder 2 machine. When you first take it out of the box, kind of go over what comes with the machine, what everything does, and what you're looking at here. So, first off, here's the machine itself, obviously. It's a chip guard on the machine already. Should be a set of A vices, which cut just about everything on the machine. We'll get into some particulars as far as the key vices go, what they do and don't cut. But the A vices, if you look on the face of the vise, you'll see an A in each spot. Those are the standard set of vices. If you access any of the materials in the manual or on the application chart, it'll tell you what side of the vise to use. But most of the time, we'll be using the A set of vices. Along with the machine, you would have gotten a kit that's got all of your depth and space rod sets in it, as well as setup keys, and I'll get into that in a moment. Also would have gotten a guarantee card. Make sure you fill that out. Include the machine serial number. The machine serial number is over here on the right side of the machine. Include your date of purchase and all the other information it asks for there to get you registered properly. When you send that in, be sure to send in your registration paperwork for your free Generacode program. And we will send you a download link once we get that for the full version of our Generacode program. Usually there's also a paper in with the machine. Talks to you about your next steps once you get a key machine. Once you buy one of our key machines, talks about registering it, what I just mentioned about the Generacode form, and talks about our website, YouTube channel, and Facebook page. Obviously, if you're here, you found our YouTube channel. Catalog comes along with the machine as well. All of our different key machines and tools are included in that. And last but not least, the instruction manual, which we'll get into here in a few minutes. Okay, next thing we'll cover are the components that you will find in the drawer that is underneath the machine. First thing you'll come across probably is the feed handle, and this will be installed on the right side of the machine. This is what brings the cutter head up and down on the machine, lowers the cutter down into the cut part of the key, or the part of the key that you will be cutting. Also inside the drawer, I'm going to find a funny little piece of black material with a screw through it. That is our handheld tip stop. This will be used for any tip stop keys on the machine, like Honda, Subaru, that type of thing. Find two Allen wrenches. One is a 3/32, which would be the smaller one. The larger one would be the 1/8-inch Allen wrench. 3/32 will be used for if you ever needed to adjust one of your depth and space rods. There's a couple of screws on the depth and space rod that you need to tighten up with that. Also, if you need to change depth and space rods, this tool comes in handy. The 1/8-inch Allen wrench is used to tighten the collet, both collets up, the one that holds the guide and the one that holds the cutter. Our second set of vices is also in the drawer. There is a chance that you may have bought a machine with just one set of vices as a special order. If you bought the standard Sidewinder 2 package, you'll have a set of vices in here. These have V's on each side, and that stands for Volkswagen. So you would use these sides of the vices to duplicate or code cut a Volkswagen key, or Audi. Porsche also uses the same profile. In the drawer, you should find three different guides. Those usually have black ends on the tubes, although those colors can change. And so you'll find three of them. There's an 093, GHMS-093, which is the 3/32 guide. A GHMS-3M, which is a 3mm guide. And a GHMS-156, which is the 5/32 guide. So in order from smallest to biggest, you have the 3/32, which is the smallest, the 3mm is the medium size, and the 156, or 5/32, is the largest of the three. To go along with that, you'll find two 5/32 cutters, GHCC-156. You'll find two 3mm cutters, GHCB-3M. And two 3/32 cutters, GHCB-093. Also in the drawer, you'll find a cutter, a 3/32 cutter in a pink tube. This is a special cutter, and it's only used for plunge cutting Lexus keys. There will be a separate video that details how to use that cutter, but again, this is not to be used to duplicate keys. This is only a code cutting cutter and only when you're doing a special procedure with it. So this cutter makes the origination of a Lexus style key a little bit easier. All right, the next thing we'll go over is the plastic kit that comes with the machine. This is what's going to hold all of your code rods. So we'll just kind of go through these one by one. This one is the Lexus long and short setup key. And three rods go with the Lexus kit. There's one space rod, or I'm sorry, two depth rods and one space rod. So this one is marked with LL, which stands for Lexus long. So this is the depth rod, which would go in the, horizontally into the machine like this. There's also one stamped LS, which is the Lexus short. So this would be the 40,000 series key. And one space rod will do the trick for both of these. So if you look at the top of this one, it's marked 1 through 5, which is the short key. If you look at the bottom set of numbers, it goes 1 through 8, and that is for the longer O series key, or the original Lexus. LX is stamped onto the throat of this one. There's also a special setup key, and if you look at it, it's cut off. About half of the key is cut off. This goes along with the pink tube cutter that I mentioned previously. And again, there will be a separate video that details the use of this key. So we'll put the Lexus setup keys away. Also in here, we're going to find the Hyundai Kia setup key. This is a Hyundai and Kia 4-track. And that pair of rods is marked HK for Hyundai and Kia. There is more than one Hyundai Kia's code rod set. The one comes with the machine again is for the 4-track. Next set we'll get into here is the GM setup key. And again, a lot of these setup keys, they'll tell you right on the tag, 3/32 C/G, 3/32 cutter and guide is what we'll use for that. So the GM rods are simply marked GM. Space rod is always longer than the depth rod, so when you put these in the machine, the stickers will reflect properly. Depth rod goes in this way, space rod goes in this way. Ford setup key would be next, and the Ford kit, and that's just marked FD. And again, two rods in here. Honda 4-track. Two rods in here, and those are marked H. And then, of course, the Volkswagen. Two rods in here for that one, and those are marked V. On the inside of the kit, you're going to find an application chart. And so the application chart is going to tell you what kit name we have here. For instance, we'll just look at the Honda kit. It's going to give you a part number. So if you were to look in our price list, the GHMS754 is the part number for that Honda kit. Show you here what code series that covers, which is the KLMN000-99. Tells you what the space rod and the depth rod have marked on them. And again, those markings are right at the throat of the, just below the black knob. So this one's marked LX. Again, that's the Lexus. But the Honda rods would be marked with an H. Cutter over here would be a GHCC156. Guide would be a GHMS156. Going to use the A set of vices, and we're going to tip stop the key and use the handheld tip stop to line that up flat with the end of the vise. That information can also be found in the back of the manual. And so again, here's our Honda information, tells us which guide and which cutter to use. Standard set of vices A, 5/32, tells us what the shallowest depth on the key is. Deepest depth, some other depth and space information. You can use this information, it's also in generic code, but to check to make sure that your keys are being cut accurately. The biggest thing to remember is that all of the rods that come in this kit with the machine are all preset to your machine. Keys have been cut on them, we know that they work, so every set of rods that comes in this kit has been calibrated for your machine. So do not adjust anything inside the plastic box. If a kit has come separately from the machine, then it probably needs to be adjusted. But if it is in that kit, then it is all taken care of already. Do not adjust it.